Hey, and I'm back, streaming with a new overlay and playing my first 3DS game on stream. This is Metroid Samus Returns. That is very exciting to see when it runs perfect. But I mean, like, Dragon Ball Fusions says it's okay, but it runs perfectly. Meanwhile, Planet Robobot says okay, and I get constant stuttering with it. So, this is my first 3DS game. The screens are kind of not balanced perfectly at the moment. Like, it looks kind of low quality on the other one. Actually, it looks okay on the stream, I guess. I don't have any images for this for the game yet. Because, honestly, I didn't realize that this would be the first 3DS game I streamed. I was kind of aiming for it to be one of the mystery dungeons. But since I'm doing the Road to Dread right now, I figured why not do the one version of Metroid 2 I haven't played yet. So I tested this. It hopefully is working okay. Oops, I forgot something important. Have a good one, dude. Look forward to seeing this probably soonish. Good. I hope you enjoy it when you play it, too. I am hopefully really going to enjoy it. Okay. Button 1. Button 2. Don't mind me saying button. That means nothing. Button 3. Button 4. After pressing OK, move your, okay, horizontally, then vertically. Okay, I think that's good. Directional pad. Obviously, I'm setting it to the pad and everything. Ooh, I like that. That's a good old school callback right there with that. Input. Okay. Let me just set that up real quick. It works! Okay, so I have a save file here from when I was testing it, you know, just because I test things. That's how it works. How do I... Oh, there we go. This looks pretty good. How's that look on stream? A little blurry. But not terrible. Give me 1 second. So again, my 3DS... Oh, that's why. Let me bump that up a bit. There we go! Now it's nice and smooth. Oh, that looks beautiful. There we go. So, my 3DS, I can up-res the graphics and make them better by overpowering it. So there's Chozo memories. There's 40 of them. I think they are quite important to the lore. Controls, missile mode, free aim, use Aeon. Amiibo, don't have it. How do I guess you have to tap to delete, yeah. Are you sure you want to erase it? Yes! Why would I want to not do that if I don't press the button? A new file will be created. In the year 20XD5 of the cosmic calendar, a Galactic Federation research team discovered an unknown life form on planet SR388. While they were able to successfully obtain a living sample, their research vessel was attacked by space pirates during their voyage home. Just want to make sure everything looks okay. This attack was no coincidence. The space pirates had set their sights on these mysterious organisms called Metroids. They planned to replicate the sample and exploit its ability to absorb energy, the energy of any life form. Their intention was to use Metroids as a weapon, one powerful enough to conquer the entire galaxy. To combat this threat, the Galactic Federation dispatched a lone bounty hunter to infiltrate the space pirate base on planet Zebes. Zebes. against all odds. Look at that. Look at that Matrix stuff that she's doing right there. She's jumping on the... Oh, wait, no, that's not a missile. That's just a platform. The floating platform is just really thin. Against all odds, Samus Aran, eradicated the Metroids on Zeebs and defeated Mother Blair. I'm glitching out. Against all odds, Samus Aran eradicated the Metroids on Zeebs and defeated Mother Brain, the leader of the Space Pirates. And so their sinister plans were thwarted, for a time. Concerned by these developments and by the great threat the Metroid species still posed to the galaxy, the Galactic Federation mounted another expedition to SR-388. A special squadron of elite soldiers from the Galactic Federation Police were dispatched to investigate. Sorry, I'm looking at the dude in the dead center there. It looks really funny because he's like this big bulky suit and it's just this guy's like tiny fucking head and neck. That looks really silly. The team soon went missing, but not before transmitting a small sampling of data back to headquarters. Also, it's nice to have a game running where I could click out of the screen and still see what's going on. Analysis of this data confirmed a Metroid presence within the interior of planet SR-388. So long as they continued to exist, these Metroids would forever pose a devastating threat to the galaxy. The resulting decision of the Galactic Federation Council... Ugh, was immediate and unanimous. Samus Aran, you must exterminate the Metroids once and for all. This is a little stuttering, not too much, hopefully. Mostly when stuff loads, there's like a second or two of stuttering. Ow. My neck. So yeah, this is Metroid 2. The Metroid 2 remake. The actual Metroid 2 remake. And not another Metroid 2 remake, which was the, again, first full game that I streamed when I started streaming regularly. I have played it. I have played through Metroid 2 original at Game Boy. Beat in under 3 hours, too, and got the best ending for it. But this is my first foray into Samus Returns. And my first foray into streaming a 3DS game, so... kind of making all sorts of strides here. So the thing that's kind of weird to me is the fact that... Shit. Ammo and energy already filled capacity. Save your progress? Yes. Save complete. It's kind of weird to me that Samus is back in her normal suit now, even in the remake, when it's kind of established that that apparently the Prime series all takes place before this game. It takes place between 1 and 2. So I'm not exactly sure what the deal with that is. Like, where did all those suits go? That movement's a little jank, but hey. So we got basic laser shooties. We get a free aim, which is cool. Kind of gives you a little more control. Missiles, which you start with in this game. Really cool. And then a melee counter, which is... Mercury Steam's little addition to the game, which I think they are carrying over into Metroid Dread. So that's cool. Ducking is a thing. It's really nice. It feels very smooth. It's also weird because this is the first time I'm playing a Metroid game with an analog stick. Rather than, a circle pad, rather than a control stick. That's a little weird. Wait a minute. Yeah, why is that, like, stopping in midair there? It's like there's a secret down there or something. Warning. While holding R, press Y to fire missiles. Bam. Blammo. Press and hold L to lock onto your enemy and to lock your position and enter free aim mode. Use control pad, circle pad to aim in the direction you wish to fire beams and missiles. And you already start with the grip in this game. And they kind of... Oh, it's not a top... Yeah, it's like the newer games. You gotta press all of them at once. Okay, real cool. It's a little weird to have to press, like, more than three buttons at once. It's kind of weird in any game. Enemies are getting a bit hostile. Poor dude. Interesting, I'm not coming across any stuttering right now. I guess maybe the game, because, I don't know. Use your melee counter right before charging and, use your melee counter right before a charging enemy makes contact to parry. After doing so, you will automatically take aim. Press X to use your melee counter now. Bam. You can just blast away. Press X to use your melee counter right before a charging enemy makes contact. So how come you cannot, oh right, the control pad does something else in this game. It's used for quick changing and stuff. Surface. So right now, obviously, I'm giving the top screen way more real estate. If you guys want the bottom screen a little bit bigger, just let me know. I can also... That's DS. I could also switch it to a vertical overlay, which gives the top screen a lot less space. And just gives the bottom screen some equal time there. But again, there's really not a whole lot going on down there. You don't need to really see the menus and stuff. So what do we got? So I can move it with the, I could do that too, okay. Basic power beam plus Y to fire consecutive shots. Got it. Standard missile subweapon that fires a powerful projectile. Hold R, then press Y to fire. Wait. Oh. I see. Energy and missile. Okay, so it shows energy and missiles. Grab a pin from the bottom of the screen and drag it to a location of interest on the map. Drag a placed pin back to the bottom of the screen to delete it. Oh! That's cool. So you can mark up to 10 spots on the map. Oh, that's actually really interesting. That could be really useful. Map icon. Samus gunship door. Controls. Move, select Aeon. Yeah, that's it. It selects an ability. Free aim, shoot, jump, melee, missile mode. Use Aeon. Okay. Last checkpoint. Return to the last checkpoint, you will lose all unsaved progress. Okay, no. Return to the last time you saved. That's cool. So you can not only reload your save at any time, but you can also just load up to the point where the game last was like, okay, here's a checkpoint. You just lose all your progress after that point. Neat. Don't have amiibo unlocked yet. SR388 surface. Okay, you can kind of switch maps. When I was testing this out, I was absolute garbage using the melee counter. It's a very clunky noise that it makes when Samus gets hit by that. I kind of wish the camera would do that neat thing every time you do that, but I can understand why it doesn't. Oh, I don't have the morph ball. For some reason. The counter system really gives me vibes of, like, Doom 2016. Just because, you know, you counter and then you get stuff from the enemies by doing that. And that's kind of how you played Doom 2016. You'd melee people to get ammo, and then you'd be able to shoot. I want that. Yeah, it's neat. I've seen a lot of people talk about and complain, like, about the differences between this game and AM2R, and how AM2R is probably a better remake. AM2R is kind of a more faithful remake. Actually, I don't know. They're both good in different ways. AM2R sticks more closely to original, like, Super Metroid Zero Mission style remake, whereas this game takes it in a different direction, and I kind of like that because, like, let's be honest, we have plenty of Metroid games in that style. The way Mercury Steam did it is very unique and cool, and it also changes how the atmosphere of this planet seems. AM2R kind of kept it more close to, like, the whole, like... Actually, I don't know. I guess visually it just kind of upgraded the what you expect the GB graphics to look like. This is more like they completely redid it to really look like Ancient Ruins. Morph Ball acquired. The compact morph ball lets you move through narrow passages. Simply push down while crouching or tap the map on the touchscreen to take them on the morph ball form. Blech. Wow. That's good shit for my voice coming out there. So you can either duck in morph ball, or if you tap the screen, it's just like instant ball. Insta-ball. Let's crush Samus' spine many times over. Missile tank acquired. Missile capacity increased by 3. Interesting that's 3 in this game and not 2. Or 5, rather. Again, it's a little weird to use the analog stick. I mean, I could, you know, I could technically map it to buttons if I want to. Oh, wait, no, I can't. Actually, no, I can. I could map it to buttons if I really want to, but then I also kind of lose the free-flowing movement. Like, I gotta remember free aim. Like, that's the whole reason this game uses the analog stick. This game introduces the other major element of Metroid 2, I believe. The poison goop, the purple. In AM2R, they kind of... I think it's kind of more just straight-up lava, whereas in this game, they make it more poisonous goop, which, you know, either or works. There's not really any major discrepancy with it. Also, like, the idea of doors just not working right. I know the other night we were also kind of getting a little in conversation about this game running at 30 FPS, but it's really not terrible. I mean, I don't think this game was really... It not being 60 doesn't really hurt it too much. Scan pulse. upgrading suit for Aeon compatibility. Aeon fuels special abilities like Scan Pulse. Refill your gauge with Aeon orbs foes may drop when you either beat them or successfully parry. Scan Pulse uses Aeon to scan an area. Use it to reveal map information and locate then the location of breakable blocks. Press up to equip, press A while equipped to activate. Cancel by pressing A again before the pulse is released. And now we get the Metroid 2 music. Guess you could cancel. And if I use it, yeah, it shows you exactly what gets revealed. That's cool. But I think it only lasts a couple seconds, and then it wears off. Or not. It actually looks like it kind of just stays unlocked. So I guess that's kind of the alternative to having a... a map system in this game, like an unlockable map. Also, did I just wall jump without realizing it? I think I did. That's the sound from... That's like almost exactly the same version of the jingle from Prime, I think. But I haven't played Prime. Oh, wow. That is way easier to do in this game. Yeah, that's a joke. Which is funny, because Metroid 2 doesn't have wall jumping originally. Yeah, that's just permanently unlocked once you scan pulse. That's cool. So it makes finding this shit way easier. Oh, I got a Metroid counter. The boy's hungry. And the amiibo option has been unlocked in the map menu. Now, if I'm not mistaken, amiibo just unlocks hard mode and just gives you some items. You have unlocked the ability to use amiibo. You can use Metroid-related amiibo to unlock special features. After your next save, you can also access the option from Samus Files whenever you wish to use an amiibo. If a compatible amiibo, touch it to the screen. I don't have a Metroid amiibo. Do I? No, I don't have... Actually, they just restocked a lot of them, too. But no, I don't have it. Oh, but if the pulse is inactive, you can't see where the breakable blocks are. Yeah, like, so you need to know that that's there. Oh, you don't even need to kick off! You just automatically do it if you press jump while near the wall. Energy fully restored. I love that. I like how the missile just boink bounces right the hell off. Also, I just noticed the Metroid counter gradually gets more beepy as you get close to one. Look, see, now it's getting red. They really want you to use that counter. At least you kind of auto-lock onto them. That's really, nice. Enemies take a fair bit more punishment to take out, too. Thank you. again, pretty decently generous with saving. Kind of a subtle hint that you need missiles here. It's the Metroids. It's so weird how little the Metroid presence is in the first game. Ow. So yeah, the whole gimmick in this game is that the Metroids hatch from the larval state. Which, honestly, I feel like is something that comes up in a lot of later games. Like, I thought that was just kind of exclusive to Metroid 2, but it is not. It is very much a thing that, comes up often. Metroid 1 is really the only time it doesn't. No, I guess Super Metroid 2. Just because Super Metroid involves, the larva Metroids. It's weird that the Metroids themselves, like, are just kind of like an egg. And that's, yet they're the kind of the face of the series in terms of enemies. Whereas their true forms are all like hatched versions. And you just don't see the hatched versions that often. Unless you're facing a Metroid Queen. So yeah, I'm happy I played this tonight, because now I'm kind of getting accustomed to it, and next time I play it, I'm going to be like full on, like, oh yeah, time to get going, buddy. Interface with those statues. Energy capacity increased by 100. Charge beam acquired. The charge beam gathers energy, which is then released all at once. This power can be used to open charge doors. Oh, so that's why those doors don't open. Press and hold Y to charge, then release Y to fire. Oh, cool. And it still gets the full refill thing back. I don't know why I couldn't just tested that out. I don't know why I had to blow Aeon energy on it. Oops. Feel the power flowing through me. I still can't get up through that green door, though. I'm assuming we get super missiles at some point, and that'll blow away the goop. Okay, there's a lot of icons on the screen now. Item sphere, unacquired item, acquired item, enemy reach, ammo, energy, ammo, save station, question mark, Chozo seal inactive, Aeon ability, big Aeon orb, gunship, charge door, question mark, Metroid defeated Metroid. Wow. They really over explain this, don't they? I guess that's modern Nintendo for you. The biggest problem I'm noticing with the counter is that it's only really intuitive for one-on-one fights. If there's a bunch of enemies in the room, you're kind of like flailing to fight them all, and then one will charge you and just like break your groove entirely. Like if there's large groups of enemies, then they shouldn't have any that charge you at that moment. Was already filled to capacity. Yeah, it's not the easiest thing to pull off. Like, I'm clearly not timing it very well. Okay, but why? Why is that built like this? Actually, I'm gonna go back up, because there's definitely a secret at the very beginning. I want to find it. Oh wait, you cannot go back up. That's a bit... it's also, yeah, it's a bit odd, actually. In the original Metroid 2, going back to your gunship was entirely possible. So that's an interesting little wrinkle on the formula here. Okay, you can do melee out of a crouch, which is fine by me. That goop. Some good goop. There we go. Now I'm getting the hang of it. Yeah, that doesn't look ominous. Thank you. Ooh, okay. Wonder what that means. Okay, but how do I... Oh, there we go. Secrets. Yellow. Well, if... I just played Zero Mission. If there's one thing Zero Mission taught me... Yellow is usually endgame. Can't bomb jump. Can't wall jump when there's no... Well, we know to come back for that, at least. Interesting. Use the elevator. No. Get anything over there just yet. I can take a look though. Hold on. There's any way down there at the moment. All right, head to the next area. That's crispy. That's chunky looking right there. Area 1. Pulse blast. Honestly, you get the Aeon energy back so quickly. There's like no point not using it right now. This music very much reminds me of Caves from Phantasy Star Online. It's got a very similar ambiance to it. More purple. Purple. Oh, that hurts you quick, too. We don't wanna touch the purple. Like that. Ah. No purple. Yeah, oh, this music is absolutely giving me PSOK vibes. Ooh, that still works. Nice. Four Troids. Four Troids Adventures. Oh, Samus, don't use that in the water! What? Ah! Just like, just electrocutes yourself? That looks unsafe. Yep. Yeah, no. And it starts playing the Ridley music. That's good. To be honest, I don't really need to be using the pin since this game keeps track of, Oh, did you see that little bug on the side there? That's a good ambience. Game keeps track of, where you've, like, seen, even with the, Aeon Blast. We won't be doing that just yet. Okay. That looks like an exit hatch. Game of patience. Ow! Bitch. Those things go really far when they charge. Oh, you can't, like, do continuous wall jumping, because one wall jump gives you the big move. Ooh, now here, red, can't break it. Yeah, I think you need something else for that, maybe an Aeon ability. Hit that one after it hits you and it still counts as a counter. Those are crumble blocks. Ain't gonna help us. Purple. That's the purple stuff. Hit the wrong button. Interesting. Bomb acquired. Nice. That's probably for purples. It is purple. A bomb specially designed to be used with a morph ball. While a morph ball form, press Y to set a bomb. I find it funny that Samus kind of just slides down a bit. Oh, okay. Okay, bomb jumping is way easier in this game. Yep, purple blocks. Okay. So we've got our way forward here. Meow. This music is very creepy. I like it. Oh, look, it's this thing again, but it's active. Yes, step on the Banjo-Kazooie brick. That looks like the switches from Banjo-Kazooie. Use teleport station. Oh, nice. That's cool. Select an area to with a teleport station that you wish to travel to. Select the teleport station you wish to travel to. Okay. So it just takes you to that one area. But I have purples now. That means I could get whatever's over there. Cool, fast travel. That's neat. Missile capacity increased by 3. That's purple. Or you or what? No, zap. Okay, good. That prompt only shows up the first time. And control pad left and right will quick select the thing. You do have to sit through this, though, presumably because the game's loading the other area in. Alright, well, we figured out stuff. More lift. Come on. Yes. There we go. See? Whoa. Game trolled me. It was like, hey, come over here, secrets. There will be a Metroid in this room. Stand on top of this? No, I can't. It's in the background. If you get the spider ball in this game, like the original Metroid 2. Hey! Speaking of... I guess it's pressed down again while you're already in morph ball form. Spider ball could stick to and move along walls and ceilings. Use while morph ball form, press L to hold L to activate. What? Wait, really? Oh my god, you actually have to hold down L. That's not very good. I'm not a fan of that. I'm gonna not gonna lie here. Okay, we gotta enter that from the right. Left, rather. Okay, but why do I have to hold the button down? That's kind of weird. I'm not a big fan of that. There it is. Very much appreciate the cinematics. Really? Really? Okay, what's going on here? What? Okay. I don't know what just happened there. What killed me? Alright, thankfully again, checkpoints. Game doesn't punish you too badly if you die. Oh, those do a shitload of damage. Also, yeah, I think I can't. Huh. I think if I try to counter while it's electrified, that doesn't work. But I'm not sure. I'm not sure if that's it, if that correlates directly to it. Or maybe I'm just doing it too early. Yeah, something's not going on right here, right? All of a sudden. I'm a little confused. Am I... Did I forget how to play this game already? In the middle of it, somehow? What's going on? What is going on? Oh yeah, no, it does do charges where it's not electrified. I'm still fucking it up in Farmville quite hard. There we go. Slurp that Metroid right the hell up. I'm gonna stop real soon, as soon as I get back to a safe spot. I like to call progress. That's what we in the entertainment business refer to as progress. Oh, you have to go that way anyway. Okay. again, I'm not too big on the toggling thing. Is there a way to maybe fix that? No? No, there's no changing anything. That's kind of weird. Alright. I'm gonna save it here. And call it a night, because it's almost 4. Ugh, God, I really don't want to go back to work tomorrow. I am not having a good time at work lately. To say the least, it's rather frustrating, and I'm not too happy with it. I'm gonna try something risky here. Okay, it worked. Whenever I play a game that's not on the native system, and in addition to saving, I tend to do the other kind of save as well, just in case the save file doesn't take. But yeah, that'll do it for tonight. Aeon abilities. Oh wait. Information location on the breakable blocks. Press. Okay. Perfect. Yeah, this is really cool. Very, very, very worthy follow-up to the original game. Just like Zero Mission was a very worthy follow-up to Metroid 1. As you have reached a milestone of item... you have reached a It's 4 in the morning. You have reached a milestone of item collection completion. As a result, new art has been unlocked in the gallery. Chozo Memories. Oh, I see. Each one is a different picture. But you can't see the whole thing unless you get all of them. Change the controls. 6.7% complete. Yeah, 2017. Hard to believe this game came out almost 4 years ago. Oh, yeah, almost 4 years ago. Got announced right after Metroid Prime 4, which also is not out. We got two side-scrolling Metroid games between when Metroid Prime 4 got announced and when it's eventually going to be released. We got two more Metroid side-scrolling games announced and released. But yeah, this was great. I am absolutely loving this. This is a new experience for me. Loving revisiting the Metroid series, too, before the Dread comes out. More of this at some point. Don't know if I'll come back to it tomorrow. Tomorrow I might actually finally do Tribal Hunter again. Just do a nice solid stream of that. Monster Hunter, I also want to do a stream and finish the low rank. And I don't know. I guess Tony Hawk at some point. I don't know when I want to start that, though. I'm not good at it, so it's going to be kind of weird regardless. But yeah, this is a nice longer stream. I'm really happy I got to go longer again. Try tomorrow too. I'll also try to get some art so I can fill up the black spots on the overlay for this. But yeah, you all have a great evening. Thank you for stopping by. Take care, and I will hopefully see you tomorrow. If you want to watch more streams, check out twitch.tv/team/wildabandon. My auto host will take you to someone as soon as the stream ends. You all have a great evening, and I will hopefully see you tomorrow. Good night.